欢迎来到环宇新知英语你同在频道，双语学习中英儿童新闻系列第十七集，2023年9月出版的十二本最佳英语童书推荐上集。双语发音、中英文文字稿以及英文生字表。
12 of the best new children's books out September 2023. It's hard to believe the first day of fall approaches.As the current heat index as I'm writing this is in the 100s. Wow, am I looking forward to fall and the temperature cooling down. At this point, I'm looking forward to winter, too. By now, I imagine most kids are back in school if they're old enough to attend. My daughter's school started at the beginning of August, and I'm happy to report that she is loving kindergarten. I hope everyone has an equally enjoyable back-to-school experience.
2023年9月出版的十二本最佳英语童书推荐上集。写这篇文章的时候，天气还很热，且酷热温度竟然高达百度，真的很难相信秋天快到了。我已经迫不及待想迎接秋天和凉爽的温度了，甚至连冬天都很期待。现在我猜大多数孩子都已经开学了，如果他们已经满足上学的年龄。我女儿的学校在八月初就开学了，我很高兴地记述她很喜欢幼儿园。我希望每个人都能有同样愉快的开学经历。
I typically dreaded returning to school. After a slower summer in terms of new children's book releases, September is off with a bang. My picks for must-read September children's book releases include many lovely books about activism.Community, hope, and celebrating identity. Interestingly, two of my September middle grade picks involve therapy dogs, Something Like Home and The Vanderbeekers Ever After, and two of my September picture book picks feature indigenous activist Autumn Peltier, Water Warrior, and Imagine a Garden. There is also lots of poetry in my picture book and middle grade choices.
我以前总是很讨厌开学。在新的儿童书发行量较少的夏天之后，九月可说是热闹非凡。我精选的必读九月儿童书发行包括许多关于倡议、社区、希望和庆祝身份的精彩书籍。有趣的是，其中的两本终极读本都涉及治疗犬，就像家一样，和凡德贝克一家的幸福时光。另外两本九月绘本选书都以原住民运动者奥特曼佩尔提尔为特色，奥特曼、佩尔提尔、水战士和想象一个花园。我的绘本和终极读本选择中也有很多诗歌。
While this is always true, it was especially hard to narrow this list of September children's book releases down to 12 titles. They are all, at times, beautiful, moving, innovative, and fascinating.There's something for every reader. Copy That, Copycat, Inventions Inspired by Animals by Katrina Tangen and Julia Orecchia. I love a good, clever STEM children's book, and this interactive board book is one of the better ones I've read. The book explores how inventions mimic animals with rhyming riddles, peek-throughs, lift the flaps, and vibrant illustrations.
虽然这始终是事实，但要从九月儿童书籍发行清单中选出十二本书真的很难。这些书都很是美丽的、感人的、创新的，以及引人入胜的。每个读者都能找到适合自己的书籍。猫咪发明家动物创意大赛，作者凯琳娜·坦根与茱莉亚·奥雷奇亚。我喜欢好看又有趣的 STEM 科学、技术、工程、数学、儿童书，这本互动式立体书是我看过的最好的一本之一。书中透过押韵的谜语、可透视的窗口、翻页和生动的插图，探索了发明如何模仿动物。
Children can learn how flippers were designed to mimic frogs, how planes emulate birds, and more.Back Matter includes a definition of biomimicry and more lift the flap learning fun. It's also a really sturdy board book that can hold up to a lot of reading. The Walk by Winsome Bingham and E. B. Lewis. A young girl and her grandmother are going on a very important walk today, a walk to vote. On the way, they collect neighbors and community members, all eager to cast their votes. Like a school of fish, they walk the busy streets, hand in hand, to the girls' school, where the adults cast their ballots.
孩子可以了解蛙鞋是如何模仿青蛙设计的，飞机又是如何模仿鸟类翅膀设计的等等有趣的知识。后面的内容包括仿生学的定义和更多轻松的学习乐趣。这也是一本非常坚固的硬页书，经得起大量翻阅的考验。散步，温身，冰汗，与E.B.路易斯。今天，一个小女孩和她的祖母要去散步，但这不是普通的散步，而是去投票的散步。她们遇到了许多邻居和社区成员，大家都迫不及待地要投票。就像鱼群一样，他们手牵手地穿越繁忙的街道，来到小女孩的学校，在那里大人们可以投下他们的选票。
This is a beautifully illustrated, heartwarming picture book about community, hope, and the importance of voting. Characters are predominantly black, brown, and Asian, and many are disabled and illustrated with mobility devices, including the grandmother. This is a vital picture book to discuss voting with kids. Autumn Peltier, Water Warrior by Carol Lindstrom and Bridget George, September 19th, Roaring Brook Press. This poetic picture book, narrated by Water itself, honors the indigenous activist Autumn Peltier and her aunt Josephine.
这是一本插图精美、充满温暖的绘本，讲述了社区、希望以及投票的重要性。书中的角色主要是黑人、棕色人种和亚洲人，其中许多人有残疾，并配有行动辅助器具，包括祖母在内。这是一本非常重要的绘本，适合与孩子们一起讨论投票议题的重要图画书。奥特曼、佩尔提尔、水战士、尤卡罗、林斯壮与布利奇、乔治，9月19日，咆哮小溪出版社。这本富有诗意的绘本，由水本身来叙述，向原住民活动者奥特曼、佩尔提尔和他的阿姨约瑟芬致敬。
Water recalls how once it was celebrated and cared for by indigenous peoples, but then more people came who did not care for the water. Grandma Josephine, however, honored the water, spoke out about the need to care for water, and taught children about the importance of water. When she died, Autumn, her great-niece, used her voice to continue Grandma Josephine's work.It's a stunning picture book about the importance of caring for the water and how anyone can stand up and speak out about environmental issues. It's perfect for reading alongside Lindstrom's previous book, We Are Water Protectors.
水回忆起他曾经是如何被原住民族所珍视和呵护的，但后来来了许多不关心水的人。然而，约瑟芬奶奶却尊重水，她大声疾呼要保护水。并教导孩子们水的重要性。当他去世后，他的曾侄女奥特曼用他的声音继续约瑟芬奶奶的工作。这是一本令人惊叹的绘本，讲述了保护水的重要性，以及任何人都可以站出来并对环境的议题发声。这本书非常适合与林斯壮的前一本书《我们是水的保护者》一同阅读。
Imagine a Garden, Stories of Courage Changing the World by Rena Singh and Hoda Haddadi. I teared up several times while reading these seven gorgeous free verse vignettes that relate true stories of people's compassion and resilience during war, poverty, and hardship. In a garden of grenades, Palestinian mother Sabiha Abu Rama uses grenade canisters as flower pots.In Imagine, Pedro Reyes creates musical instruments from 6,700 illegal weapons. Singh also writes about indigenous activist Autumn Peltier, Brazilian gymnast and dancer Tuani Nascimento, and more. Colorful collage illustrations accompany each vignette.
想象一个花园，勇气改变世界的故事，作者：丽娜·辛格· 吉和达哈达迪。我在阅读这七篇美丽的自由诗小品时，好几次都忍不住流泪。这些小品讲述了真实的故事，关于人们在战争、贫穷和困境中展现出的同情和韧性。在《榴弹花园》中，巴勒斯坦母亲萨比莎·阿布·拉哈玛用手榴弹筒做花盆。在《想象》中，佩德罗·雷耶斯用6700件非法武器制作乐器。辛格还写了关于原住民运动者奥特曼、佩尔提尔、巴西体操选手和舞者图安尼、纳西门托等人的故事。每篇小品都有色彩缤纷的拼贴插图。
Back matter includes more details about the people behind the vignettes. This is ideal for older children, first grade and up. Something, Someday by Amanda Gorman and Christian Robinson, September 26th, Viking Books for Young Readers. Poet Amanda Gorman teams up with award-winning illustrator Christian Robinson in this hopeful picture book about how children can help enact change. You are told / that this is not a problem. The picture book opens, the illustration showing a child looking worriedly at a heaping pile of trash on the sidewalk.
后记包含更多关于这些小品背后人物的细节。这本书非常适合一年级以上的儿童。未来的某件事，阿曼达·戈尔曼及克里逊·罗宾森合著。诗人阿曼达·戈尔曼与获奖插画家克里逊·罗宾森合作，创作了这本充满希望的绘本，讲述了孩子们如何可以帮助改变世界。绘本一开始就写道：你被告知，这不是问题。插图展示了一个孩子忧心忡忡地看着人行道上堆积如山的垃圾。
You are told that this cannot be fixed, Gorman continues as the boy begins cleaning. Slowly, the child cleans, and eventually, other children join him. It's not easy, but together, they plant a garden, and then the entire community begins to help take care of it. This is a book about how everyone, no matter how young, can make a change for the better by addressing community needs and taking action. Every Dreaming Creature by Brendan Wenzel. Fans of Brendan Wenzel's previous books, They All Saw a Cat, A Stone Sat Still, will love this picture book, which I think is his most beautifully illustrated to date.
你被告知这个问题无法解决，高曼继续写道，当男孩开始清洁。慢慢的，当这个孩子开始打扫，最后，其他孩子也加入了他。这不是一件容易的事，但他们一起种下了一座花园，然后整个社区都开始帮忙照顾他。这是一本关于每个人，无论年纪多小，都可以通过解决社区需求和采取行动来做出更好改变的书。每一个梦想的生物，布兰登·温泽尔著，喜欢布兰登·温泽尔之前书籍，他们都看到了一只猫，一块石头做得很安静的读者一定会喜欢这本绘本。我认为这是他迄今为止最美丽的插画作品。
The narrator dreams they are various animals, including a sleeping salamander, a drifting octopus, a sneaking tiger, and more. In each dream, they're woken up, and when they dream again, they're another animal. The illustrations are bright and dreamlike, while the story is poetic and evocative.Saving Sunshine by Sadia Faruqi and Shazleen Khan. Twins Zara and Zishan could not be more different, and they're constantly bickering because of it. The family flies to Florida when their mother is informed she will be honored as Pediatrician of the Year at a medical conference in the Florida Keys.
叙述者梦见自己变成一只睡着的蝾螈，一只漂浮的章鱼，一只偷偷摸摸的老虎等等。在每个梦中，我都被吵醒了。当我再次做梦时，我又变成另一种动物。插图色彩鲜明如梦似幻，而故事则是充满诗意而令人回味的。拯救阳光，萨迪亚·弗拉奇及沙兹林·汉著， 双胞胎姐妹萨拉和泽西安性格是天差地别，也因此经常争吵不休。当他们的母亲得知他将在佛罗里达群岛的一次医学会议上被授予年度儿科医师奖时，全家飞往佛罗里达州。
This is nerve-wracking for all of them, as Pakistani-American Muslims, security frequently pulls them aside. The twins' bickering reaches new heights, and their parents take away their phones and force them to spend time together in the Florida Keys. When they discover a sick turtle, they might have actually found something they can work together to fix. This gorgeously illustrated middle-grade graphic novel provides a glimpse into the life of Muslim-American preteens.End of part one of two, with a vocabulary list following.
这对他们全家来说都很紧张。作为巴基斯坦裔美国穆斯林，他们经常被安全人员拦下来。双胞胎的争吵达到了新的高度，他们的父母把他们的手机拿走，并强迫他们一起度过在佛罗里达群岛的时光。当他们发现一只生病的海龟时，他们可能真的找到了一些他们可以共同努力解决的问题。这本精美的终极绘本为我们提供了一窥美国穆斯林青少年生活的机会。上集结束，后面还有生字表哦。感谢您的收看与支持，欢迎在留言区分享您的看法和建议，您的反馈是我们坚持与持续进步的动力。如果您觉得我们频道对您有帮助，请记得订阅、按赞、分享和开启小铃铛。祝大家有个美好的一天。